Okay, the recording is now on and we're doing a mock test, albeit a very short one with Sanjiv. We've come out of the test centre at Shirley and he set himself up with his cockpit sequence of things in the car. The examiner will basically expect whoever's doing the test to have driven to the test centre. So they won't need to hear you or see you set things up. They'll just say, you know, you've got everything set the way you like it. That's basically all they'll do.
Okay. Are we not doing show me tell me? Or?
I will do the show me tell me before we switch the engine on.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Do you want me to?
If you want to.
Have you revised them enough? Are you happy that I'm going to ask you a couple of them?
I guess you could if you want.
All right, let's give it a go then.
Okay.
Okay, Sanjiv, before we get going then, I'm going to ask you two safety questions about the car. The first one is, where would you look to find the recommended tyre pressures for your car, for your vehicle?
You could.
And how would you know that the tyres are at the correct pressure?
Well, you could refer to the car's manual and you could use a pressure gauge to check the pressure of the tyre.
Okay, thank you very much. And the second question is, can you show me, please, how you would wash and wipe the front windscreen of the car?
Well, what you would do is you would go to the left-hand stalk and there's three settings. You would push it upwards for a first setting. The second one makes it a bit faster, and the third one does another one.
Okay.
But it would be all controlled from this stalk here.
Okay. Those positions are good for telling me how to make the wipers operate, but what about washing and wiping the front windscreen?
Washing them, you would pull it towards you.
Okay, can you show me that, please?
Okay, so the ignition is on, and you can pull it towards you.
That's fine.
And if there is a bit more water left on and you want to get a clearer vision, you could push it upwards.
That's fine. Thanks very much, Sanjiv. Or shall I call you Sanj, just to make it easier? It's up to you.
Whatever you like.
I know you said when we first met that your friends call you Sanj, but I don't know whether I'm your friend in an examiner mode. Who knows?
Okay, I guess. We can leave
or it. Mr. Kumar, it's up to you.
I don't mind.
Do you remember the comedy show, The Kumars at number 20?
Oh, I've got enough.
I'm sure you've had
I've got
of
so
that.
Much of that in high school.
I've only just thought of that. Okay.
Jesus.
We won't be on the road for 38 to 40 minutes because we don't have enough time for that, but I'll try and fit in as much as I can without overstressing you.
Okay.
You can drive on whenever you're ready, please.
Okay. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put the clutch down, I'm going to put the ignition on, put it into reverse in gear, because we're going to go back a little. But before you do that, I'm going to put my hand on the handbrake and look all around, because I'm going to be doing a bit of reversing, looking around. And we have got a car coming this way, so I'm going to wait until it's cleared. Quick look again. And I'm not going to be signalling, and I'll be going backwards, looking in the direction going until you've got enough room to manoeuvre outwards. Put the clutch down and brake, okay. Put it into first gear. I'm gonna have a quick look around before you go off again. Prepare it. That blind spot. I am gonna let people know what I'm doing just in case. And come outwards. It's gonna be very slow, you're only gonna be in gear one here. I'm gonna put that fully downwards. And
I'll give you directions where I want you to go. We're gonna be taking the next road on the left, please. The next road on the left is just after the black BMW that's after this white car that's parked on the
left. Next road on the left, you've got a pedestrian crossing coming up here. Are you going to be giving any way? No. Okay, so we are going to be telling people we're doing after the black car here. Single left. Okay. Have a look. Is there anybody coming there? No. It's okay. Now do remember you got lane positioning. Turn that off. Remember to stay in your own lane.
Just to remind you, you are now in a two-way road.
Okay.
At the end of the road, I'd like you to go left, please. At the end of the road.
End of the road, left. You want you to go mirrors and signal. Give this guy enough space. Remember, enough lane positioning. Get into the position you want. Bite and go left.
At the roundabout, follow the road ahead. Second exit, please.
Second exit. You want you to go have a look, and you've got enough space. Let's go. Go at a safe speed, exit before the one you want, have a quick look, and you can cancel. Make progress. Get enough speed before you change that gear. Check your mirrors. You got a BMW heading this way. Can you make that gap in a safe speed? I am going to reduce my speed. Check your mirrors before making progress. them coming into first in this one. Have a look, make sure, and get to that boy, and off we go. Cancelled signal. Get enough gas before you change gear. Check your mirrors. Stay well in your lane. Gas before bite.
Take the next road on the right, please.
Next road on the right. Centre, right. You're in second gear already, as it is. Reducing speed. You've got a Golf coming this way. Put your clutch down. Going to roll into first and follow the car behind.
And pick a safe and convenient place to pull up on the left, please.
See, wants to pull up on the left, right mirror, left, and pull up right, here. Start covering your clutch, bringing it down and parking up. About here. Hit the curb, handbrake, neutral.
Thank you very much, and drive on when you're ready. I will be asking you to pull up a handful of times and driving on again.
Before you go again, Sanjiv, keep your hand on the handbrake and give it a bit of gas. Check you all around. Is anybody going to benefit? There is a car coming, so I'm going to wait. And then another one. And then another one. I'm hoping that's going to be the last one. So do start looking around now. You are going to be moving off. Checking that blind spot and off you go. Put the clutch fully down, not the clutch, the handbrake fully down.
Take the next road on the left, please.
Okay. Check your mirrors before you do. Braking, 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 and making progress. Check your mirrors before you signal Sanjiv.
Most drivers on test can't judge exactly what car length is. That's fine, and drive on when you're ready, please.
Gear down, having a look around, keep your hand on the handbrake, left, centre, right, check that wrong blind spot. Anybody going to benefit from the signal? Possibly. He is coming out. Possibly, check that wrong blind spot as you're coming out again, and go. Okay. Around that corner, reduce speed if you need me. Check in the mirrors. Yes, it's safe to go.
At the end of the road, turn right, please.
Center, right, signal, second gear, center, position yourself, first gear, left, right, gas, light. Let's go. And make progress. Second gear. Centre, right. Do not be cutting any lanes. Go at a safe speed. Can you make that gap? Yes, you can. Second gear. It's called shoulder. Right. Third gear. You got that Mercedes coming. Gonna come down to second gear. Gonna check before I move out. And off you go again. Come into your own lane again. Stay well in your own lane. Have some lane discipline. Second gear.
At the end of the road, turn right, please.
End of the road, he wants you to go right. So do start preparing soon. You're in second gear, which is good. And leave it in second gear. And start signalling about now, as I can shift my mirrors. I am going to give way, as is a give way sign. Do position yourself correctly. And stop about there. He's signaling to turn left, and I have got enough speed, enough to go. Just at the speed of that van, make progress, and go to gear two. Check mirrors before speeding up again.
At the roundabout, take the third exit, please. That's to the right.
Third exit to the right, so I'm going to leave it in second gear. Mirrors. One, two, three. So, yes, I think a signal benefited here. So yeah, come to a halt. Checking what's behind me as well. That bus is probably away as well. Check your mirrors before you go again, and off we go. Pedestrian crossing, there's no pedestrians. Well, there is, but she's still on her side. Checking your mirrors, second gear. Progressed gear three. What's up ahead?
Normally on a driving test, I would park you first to ask you, before asking you to start the independent driving section of the test.
Okay.
But since we're pressed for time,
yep.
I'd like you from now on to follow the signs for Birmingham or Birmingham City Centre, please.
He wants you to go for Birmingham City Centre. So start keeping your eyes out for signs for Birmingham City Centre. Keep the left lane, start braking, braking, clutch down. Tyres and tarmac. You got a red light, you can see that. Handbrake, I'm gonna leave it, put it in first gear. Got that coming up, gas, bike, clutch hand. Okay, that's okay, put your foot down. Emergency services, mirrors, and you got a bus. Okay, that's okay, Sanjiv. Take your time, don't be anxious. He asks you to follow signs for Birmingham. Got a car on the right. Might need to pull out. Okay, that's not any good. Wow. And off you go again. Follow signs for Birmingham. And that was the first.
It was the first exit.
The first exit, okay. Again, and it's safe to go. Second gear. Try to remember your signs. Okay, so Birmingham. Signal before you come into that left lane. Is it safe to do so? Have you got a safeguard? Make some speed. Hoping you see my signal, and that's okay. And change gear. Coming to first gear, could have made a smoother braking. I'm gonna put the handbrake on, leave my foot on the clutch. I am gonna be looking over to the right. And you're about to go. Let's go. So just keep going straight. I haven't seen any other signals as of yet. Change gear. Stay well in your own lane. You got a green traffic light signal before the one you want, and off you go. You're going to be coming into the right hand lane. Check that you do have enough safe space. And there you go. Go to third gear. Keep your hands on the probably don't need to change gear. I'm going to stop here. Come back up and off you go again. Leave the signal on, turn it off, and then go. Make some progress. Change gear. Mirrors. Second gear. Third gear.
Getting the train back from King's Norton station instead of Shirley? Or have you got a ticket from Shirley?
That's a very good question.
Don't worry, concentrate on your driving.
Bite, cast down, check your mirrors, release.
Let's go left.
Go left mirror, signal. Checking, braking, you can follow him behind, yes you can. Put the signal back on.
I think that little car went through on a red light actually.
That one in front?
Yeah.
Okay.
Because it's three-way traffic control.
He didn't look keen. Can you make that gap? Yes, you can. Slow enough. You're in second gear. Make some progress. You're on a hill. Get plenty of speed. And then change gear. Am I okay? I'm not sure.
If you've got a ticket already, a return ticket.
I did buy it from Langley Green.
Okay.
To
Shirley.
And return.
Okay.
I'm not sure if it will work because...
That's fine.
I mean...
I'll get you back to Shirley. That's fine.
One, two, three. Three mirrors. Going to the left. Slow, 27 miles per hour. I'm trying to think, can I actually go from King's Norton?
It doesn't matter. It's all right. It'll be a different line as well, but I don't know if the ticket says on it, Shirley.
Can you make that gap? There is a person there, so reduce your speed significantly. That's what you said last time as well. Change, brake, come down to second gear. Can you make that gap? Yes, we can, very slow. There might be a person there. It's good to check anyway. So it's good that you did. And speed up again. If you did that so fast, that would have been a serious fault.
At roundabout, go left, please. First exit.
Roundabout, go left. Mirrors, signal. pedestrians here, and off you go. Should have left a better distance. I am signaling to go right, so let's have a look. No need to. Okay. Signal is cancelled. Check the mirrors. Go to second gear. Oh, I just got a static shock there.
Did you?
I think so. I'm not sure if it helps a static shock. And then gear three.
Take the next road on the right, please.
Next road on the right. Braking. Touchdown. No pedestrian. Mirrors. Signal. Lane discipline, Sanjiv. Experience, you said that a lot of people got lanes, but no, that is not what we want.
Okay, after these next two parked cars on the left, just pull up on the left. You can all drop curbs on this occasion.
And that's safe. No hitting curbs this time. And there you go. Is that okay? Yes, about curbs. Handbrake, neutral.
Thank you very much. We've now got the reversing manoeuvre. I'd like you to reverse around the car that's parked in front, that Honda.
Okay.
So draw forwards, take up a position alongside him, and then try and complete your reversing manoeuvre within two car lengths of that car.
You want you to do a parallel park within two car lengths. Okay, so
you can begin when you're ready.
Do that. We are on a hill, so do keep gas. Find that bite. Observe, wait for that black car before you start your observations. We've got another one coming this way, that's nothing to do with us. Check that blind spot. You can't forget that blind spot, Sanjiv, and off you go. And you want you to do a parallel park, so good thing to do on this one is to start braking about. Okay, so handbrake, reverse. Now I'm gonna open up here. I'm gonna let the people know what we're doing. I have got my thing down as well. Both of these down. I'm gonna see what the people are gonna do behind me. You're in reverse gear. And prepare the car. That's okay, we're only going to be doing rolling. Are they waiting? You were looking before you go. Listening to them. He's waiting. Then start your observations.
Now remember, if the boots start to come out,
that's when you... Okay, he wants to go. So you stop in that case. Okay, start your observation before you go again. He's flashing
to give you away, I think.
And check that blind spot before you go. No, okay, there you go. There you go. Start about now. One turn to the left, keeping observation, what's going on around you. About one to two car lengths behind, make sure what's going on. Okay, straighten up. What's that car behind us doing as well? You want to make sure. Find that bite and start straightening up. He wants you about one or two car lengths, and you're not on the road anymore, so there's no need to signal. Check before you go in the direction that you're going, and look in that blind spot as well. You are in reverse gear, so just do straighten up. Have a look in that mirror. And ask yourself, Sanjiv, are you happy with that? He asked you in two car lengths.
That's fine.
Okay.
Thank you.
In that case, put the handbrake and
secure,
on.
Secure your car. That's fine. And you can switch off your engine, make yourself comfortable. That is the end of the test.
Okay.
What is the time? 20 past, I think. So I think we're probably done. Yeah, we started at 10:50.
Okay.
So just give me a moment to complete my paperwork.
We won't have time for the other manoeuvre, will we?
We've done it. This is the parallel part. You only get asked to do one manoeuvre.
Really?
You may, yeah, yeah.
Oh,
you don't
okay.
have to do two. You still have to do two, but don't have to do two these
oh,
days.
Oh, wow. I never knew that.
Yeah, that's fine.
That's probably why the tests are a lot less timely, no?
Maybe so. Okay, let me just complete my paperwork.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, and man. Congratulations, oh, Mr. Okay. Kumar. You have passed your test. There were 10 minor faults.
Okay.
I was being moderately strict with my marking.
Okay, I'm happy that you say that.
I will, because of time, yes. I will get you to back to Shirley. We'll swap okay. over, and I will send you this by email with okay. some notes. But there's nothing significant to worry about other than the consistent use of the handbrake.
Okay.
It's all right, don't worry.
Okay.
Don't worry, we can always sort that out next time.
I'm not a very good student, I haven't paid.
Yes, you are. No, you're fine. Time. You're fine.
Okay.
Okay, I'll just set my mirrors.
I am sorry that we went over time.
No,
as
no,
well.
No, no, no. I allowed it to. That's fine. I've got somebody starting in 10 minutes, but I will send them a text to say I'll be a few minutes late. And this gives me a chance to talk about the 10 minor faults. The closest you came to not passing, and
yeah.
the recording is still on, which is good.
Okay.
Because it's a chance for me to give you a debrief on while being recorded. I'll put the windows up just so that we've got a good... acoustic in the car. The closest you came was when you were checking very correctly, very diligently into your right door mirror. We were approaching a large-ish roundabout in Shirley, and there was a black single-deck bus in front of us, and you were checking to see if it was safe to pull out to get around the bus.
Yeah.
And the bus had been signalling to the left, but I don't think you were keeping an eye on his signal.
Oh, yes, to the right.
And he changed his signal to the right.
Yes.
And he started to move out, and I think you
and
assumed
I nearly saw you put your foot brake down
yeah.
as well, and I put it down before you.
Yes.
And if I didn't do that, then I would have failed.
Yes.
Okay.
Because you did manage to stop your car. I think you had assumed that the bus was going to be moving off in a gentle pull away, whereas in fact there was a double-decker white bus in front of it, causing it to come out into lane two. So if you can't see in front of a vehicle, always assume that you don't know what it's going to do.
Okay.
I'm going to put my wipers on to automatic because I've noticed a little bit of rain starting to come. A little bit of drizzle, which is only going to get worse. So I gave that as a minor fault. I didn't have to touch the foot brake, so the examiner didn't take any physical action or verbal action to tell you to do something. I left you to your own devices, and you made the right decision. You know, it was fairly strong braking.
Do you think the examiner would have...
I think they would have done the same.
Okay.
I gave you a fault for lack of anticipation. So the thought process that should have occurred is the bus is currently signalling left, but it might change. So as well as checking in my right door mirror, I need to keep an eye on his signal. As soon as he stops signalling left, I'm going to give up on the idea of trying to go past him. Because I don't know whether he's going to move out into lane two. He might stay in lane one, but he might not.
Okay.
Parking brake, three times. I gave you a minor fault for it not going all the way to the floor. So like I'm going to do here, as soon as that silver car goes, thump it down to the floor.
Thump it down. Get that sound.
That's right. Get the sound.
Get that sound. And then you have confirmation that the foot brake, not the foot brake, the handbrake is down.
That's it. Two times, maybe three, but you sorted it out very briskly on one occasion. The speed did creep above 30. It actually got up to 35, I think, on one occasion. On the other two occasions, it was about 33.
Okay.
So just keep your eyes glancing down. Tune your ears into what sound the engine would make. If it's in gear four, it'll be a little bit of a grumbly sound like this. If it's in gear three, it'll be a slightly more lively sound. There is a speed limiter that you can turn on. I can't remember if we've explored that before. So I'm twisting this little stubby stalk, and it now says above the speed limit on the digital display, limit pause. If I use the button at the top to move that up to 30, and I then press the end of that control, it would bring on the speed limiter.
Yeah.
And what that does is when I get up to 29 miles an hour, the accelerator pedal starts to go a little bit dead.
Okay.
Left. I'm a bit late with my signal there. I gave you one minor fault for the timing of signal on Trittyford Road. Don't worry, you don't know what the road names are. We had a double-deck bus in front of us that started signalling to pull into a bus stop, and you started thinking and talking about going for a possible overtake.
Oh yes,
that's all quite correct.
That long road.
But you had a road on the right, so anybody following you would have thought, ah, the learner car is going to be turning right. Okay. So it's good thinking to give the bus driver information. Here, I've checked my centre mirror, I'm slowing down, now I've got a view, now we go back on the gas and make progress. And I'm going to be taking the next on the right. Mirror, signal, nobody coming towards me that's using this space where the white arrow pointing across my road is, so I can move in nice and early, that helps me to maintain more speed. Your lane discipline was very good throughout. I'm just trying to recall what other faults there might have been. I gave you a really difficult reverse park. I deliberately chose a place where the road was quite narrow because of the park car on the right-hand side. You did very well to thoroughly check that the moped behind and the blue Rover in front were waiting. The Rover flashed his lights and then about 2 seconds later decided to come through the gap anyway. You held your position. You'd emphasised your position by using a left signal. That was good. You waited until it was absolutely safe to go. You then weren't rushed into doing it fast because you had people waiting, and I wanted to check out that you were able to keep yourself nice and
calm.
That's the word. I was going to say safe. I didn't mean safe. I'll just pull in here, actually. I'll send a text to my next student.
I do apologise for that.
No, that's not your fault. I've decided to allow it to overrun because I think it is important to give you the most information that you want. It was fine that you had your left signal on while you were doing the reverse park.
Okay.
It was superfluous by that point while you were actually moving back in behind the car, but you don't get faulted for...
I hit the curb as well, didn't I?
You touched the curb.
Okay.
So, yes, I should have given a minor fault for that. That's not on the marking sheet at the moment.
That's
so
not serious. 11.
No. Okay. Not at that speed. You were conscious as soon as you'd done it. Could have done, but actually sitting out in the road taking extra time to do that's probably not such a good idea in that scenario. I think I've covered most of the minor faults. I won't bother looking at the iPad to talk through the rest on the recording because I'll be emailing you that anyway.
Okay.
And I'll send some notes with it. So unless you've got any questions about anything?
No, I don't think so.
Okay, but if they occur to you when you're watching the video, Or while you're on the train, just text me or email me or ask me.
Okay.
In whatever form. I'll end that recording there.
Okay.
And I'll turn the engine off so that when I take my belt off to reach for the camera, it doesn't bring the engine back on. And I'll just send the next guy a message.